So back in the 1920s and 30s, it was a movie theater, or a stage theater, as they had them back then. And then after that, that lasted until about the 70s, and it was an empty building for a while, then people used it as a factory. After the factory came in, there was a baseball academy here for about 20 years for batting and hitting practice, and then we came in 2009, and we've been here ever since. You can kind of look around, there's still, we've covered up a little bit, but up high you can still see that there's the copper foil that's on there. It's there for historical preservation purposes, and so we were unable to take it down. Well, they said that it was up there for historical preservation status, and they want to get the building labeled that because it's, I think it was the first movie theater in Bridgeport. And so with that, they didn't want to ruin the chance of getting that should ever some future owner decide to pursue it.
All right, so this is the lobby. This is the lobby area. This is where I assume people came in to the theater. Maybe over here in my desk area was where they took the tickets. Some concessions over here. Over here in the kitchen area, maybe they had some concessions over here. Right now we use this as our, my mom tries to be the paleo guru. And when we host level one seminars, she'll usually put up a menu item up there, something that she's making, and we sell coffee, eggs, water, PaleoKits, Larabars, nuts, and always take care of the trainers.
So one of the newest inventions we have at CrossFit KOP is our jungle gym. Our adults, we're always looking for something to do, so we wanted a 6-foot wall, and we have an 8-foot wall as well, and we have the monkey bars in the back, actually, after we saw the killer cage of the games. And it's just a place when we had 4 muscle-up stations in the past that kind of limited it as more and more people in our box were able to do muscle-ups. And so we were able to add 8 more stations over here as well. We built other stations outside, so we have scales for people that are doing rope climbs. They can do their rope pulls that way. And so there's a lot of things that we can do that we didn't even begin to experiment with yet. And we built it so it can come out, and there's a bunch of opportunities that are yet left untapped. Before we came, it was a big empty space with a stage that was there so that everything, curtains and everything can be above. And you see that the heritage of the gym is still here with the Leo the Lion from MGM. So kind of neat, our last name is Lion, so it's kind of fitting, that's why we kept him there.
And I think about, what is it, Jace, 28,000 cars a day?
As you can see.
And then in the back, if you see, this is actually where the, you can see how the building is flat and then comes up. That's where the actual theater was in the back. So a higher theater in the back. This is our machine. We stock it with PaleoKits and Larabars and nuts. PaleoKits, Larabars, PaleoKrunch. We've got some beef jerky, coconuts, and strawberries. Danny really likes the coconut cream Larabar, which I believe that is why he ran out to his car to get.
Well, actually, I'm gonna try it. The blueberry muffin's a favorite as
oh,
well.
Oh, you like the blueberry muffin?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
I like still like the coconut cream. Hopefully it'll come out. There it is. Success. The vending machine was here when we got the facility. This is just a room right now. We use it for our coaches and for the kids, basically, and just storage. My dad's building. My dad's built everything, so he every time he sees something that sort of looks like a mess, he builds us a new shelf or a new box. One last board we have is the double underboard. So if you were able to string 100 double unders together, you get on 100 double underboard.
This is our 4th location. We started out in a gym, moved into a 400 square foot facility. If you kind of picture it, there was 4 mats wide by 4 mats deep if you guys are normally used to dealing with mats. Tiny little space. One day we were running Jackie with 1 rower and 18 people showed up for class. It was time to go shopping, so we moved into a 1,500 square foot facility. We were there about 3 months until we were getting about 40 people per class. We realized that we needed to offer more classes and move to a bigger space, and so we moved in here, and now we have 6,000 square feet of usable floor space and 8,500 square foot total.